Commission and Member States must take immediate action to introduce EU's much-delayed seamless European airspace. Its redesign into an integrated air traffic control system would mean shorter routings and quicker journeys, lower costs, fewer emissions. And it would significantly reduce emissions. We estimate that you could see a 10% reduction or 18 million tonnes of CO2 being saved every year. The modernisation of European airspace is both urgent and long overdue. We could do it tomorrow, yet politicians have been discussing this issue for over 18 years. It's now time for action. Christina.
Yeah, yeah.
Thank you, Willie. We see on the next slide, because you talked about the structural issues that we have in the European airspace, which are as bad as they are, but we also, they're compounded by strikes. And often we have very short-term strike action. Last year, the majority of strikes was in France, in Marseille, as you pointed out, often on the weekends without really having any idea of what is it that people want to stop the strikes and really impacting passengers flying on the weekend on holiday, which is not how you want to start your holiday.
The information again is that the ATM is dysfunctional, still dysfunctional in the EU. So I would say it's an opportunity for the new European Commission, the new European Parliament, to finally start working on this dossier, which has been stuck for way too many years. When I talk about this dossier, it's of course the single European sky. We would be assured of, which looks like a truly seamless cross-border airspace, which would enable us to fly more efficient routings. So it is possible. We know exactly what needs to be done. Now the Commission needs to put it into a new regulation. It would also provide us with more competitive service provision, and that's very important. You mentioned, Christina, rightly so, the monopoly position. In the absence of competition amongst NSPs, because that is a possibility, unfortunately, it would actually still establish an independent economic regulator. So the European Commission is actually prepared and really pushing to get this done. Even if it's at national level, we need economic independent economic regulator. We already have the tools which are needed to fix our inefficient airspace once and for all. All the stakeholders have been sitting around the table for the past 12 months, whether it's Eurocontrol, the airspace users, together with the European Commission. So we know exactly what needs to be done. At the end of the day, the airlines are not the managers of the ANSPs. The ANSPs as suppliers are really failing to provide a good service at an affordable cost.
Airlines are obliged to pay compensation or right to care to our passengers when for these delays. You know, notionally, the legislation says we can recover those costs from the ANSP providers, but in almost every EU country, the ANSP is protected or is immune from legal action or prosecution. So not alone are we and our customers suffering these enormous and unjustified delays, but we're having to pay out huge amounts of money to in right to care and in some cases compensation costs as a result of the failure, lamentable failure, of some of these ATC providers to just show up to work on Saturdays and Sundays.